السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن شاء الله today I'm gonna talk about the first project on Mass 101, which is about building a better roller coaster. And when I say that better, I mean I want to build a smoother and more comfortable one. And before starting, I would like to remind you, now we use the MATLAB as a calculator. Be careful. You have to understand the idea of the project, and if you get some trivial calculations, you can do it by your hand and then complete the rest using the MATLAB program. So let's start. Our project divided into three parts. The first part, I just focus on the first ascent and the first drop. Be careful. The first ascent and the first drop, only in the first part. And the second part, I would like to modify this first part. We will see. And for the third part, I will design the complete track. So let's start. What's the problem statement? Suppose that you are asked to design the first ascent and the first drop for a new roller coaster. And we have some assumption here. If we assume that the slope of the ascent is equal 0.8, and the slope of the drop is equal minus 1.6. And be careful, this assumption, we will use it for the first, second, and the third part. So the slope of the ascent, 0.8, the slope of the drop minus 1.6, and it's clear. For the ascent, the slope is positive, and for the drop, the slope is negative. And what's your objective here? Your objective to get what's the function f. Here, if we assume for this the first ascent and the first drop, we assume that this function is a parabola f of x just equal ax squared plus px plus c, just a parabola quadratic function. So I want to determine what's the function f. And I want to see what's L1, what's the tangent line here, and what is the tangent line for the drop L2. So now I have three functions, f of x and L1, L2. So let's see. Here f is equal ax squared plus bx plus c, and we have L1 and L2, we can get it. And for the first part, I have an assumption that if you have the horizontal distance between these two points, B and Q, is equal 100. Be careful. Here, we assume that for the first part, part one, we assume the horizontal distance between B and Q is equal 100. So the distance now from B and Q is equal 100. And if I say that the distance between B and Q, it's 100, we can't use it. So it is useful if we say that the point B is the origin, it's 0, 0, and we can determine what's the point Q, or what is this point. So if we say that this is the function F, and we have two points, so this is 0, 0. And what is this point? The horizontal distance is equal 100. So the x coordinates here is equal 100, and the y coordinates is the function at x is equal 100. These coordinates, it's not important for us, but the x coordinates, we'll use it. So now, we have the function f of x, we have L1, we have L2, and we have two points, B and Q. So we can use it to determine what is the function F. As I said before, we use the MATLAB as a calculator. It means there is some trivial calculations, you can do it by your hand, and then use the MATLAB to complete the rest. So let's see. Now we have the function F, and the point 0, 0. And we know that this point 0, 0 lie on the function f. So it satisfies the equation of the function f. So let's see. Now we have the function f of x is equal ax square plus bx plus c. And we have the point 0, 0 lie on this function. So it satisfies the equation of this function. So f0 is equal to 0, is equal 0 plus 0 plus c. So the constant c is equal to 0. So it's done. By yourself, by your hand. And what's the derivative at 0? If we say the slope of the ascent line is equal 0.8, so the derivative of the function f at 0 is equal 0.8. So f prime at 0 is equal 2ax, and if you substitute with 0 is equal to 0, plus b is equal 0.8. So we have the point b is equal 0.8. So now we get the constant c, the coefficient c, and the coefficient b. Now we have f of x. What's the function f of x? Now f of x is equal ax squared plus 0.8x. This is your function f of x. Okay. And what's L1? L1 is easy. L1 is equal 0.8x. Why? Because this is a slope. And if we say that plus c, c this is equal to 0. Why? Because it's a 0, 0 lie on this line. So now, what's your information for the function f? Now, the function f also, the derivative of the function f at 100 is equal minus 1.6. Why? Because the slope of the function f at 100 is equal minus 1.6. So f prime at 100 is equal 2ax, 2a times 100 plus 0.8. This is equal minus 1.6. So now we can use the MATLAB to get what's the unknown variable a here. We have an equation and we can get what's the variable a here. Let's see. Now we will use the MATLAB. As I said before, we use the MATLAB as a calculator. This is the first part. It's very trivial. It's very trivial. So the first part, we just find B and C by your hand, and we can use the MATLAB to get the coefficient A and then to get L1 and L2, and after that you can plot it. So let's see. This is the MATLAB. We have an equation, as you said, A 2AX 2A 100 plus 0.8 is equal minus 1.6. And we can write it since x, we have a here, same as a, and I just want to solve this equation. So I just equal it, or called it equation 1, is equal 2 times a times 100 plus 0.8 equal minus 1.6. And we took in the class, what's the difference between this equal and this double equal? Be careful. Here, this double equal, it means that this is the left hand side equal the right hand side. But equation 1 equal, only 1 equal, it means I called this equation by equation 1. Be careful from that. So this is equation 1. So I want to solve it. So I just write A equal solve equation 1 comma A. I want to solve it. So let's see. So this is A. This is A. Okay, let's see. Be careful, this is 1 minus 1.6. Minus 1.6. So this is the A. We have A now. So can you write the function f? Yes. This is sense x. What's your function f? F of x is equal. Let's see. This is f of x. Ax squared plus my 0.8x. So A times x square plus 0.8 times x. This is the function f of x. It's clear? This is the first part. Now, we finished. We get f of x. You can write L1. L1 is easy. Why? Because L1, what's the function L1? This is a line, tangent line. We can say that L1 is AX, MX plus C. What's M? The slope. What's C? The point here, 0, 0. So it satisfies the equation. So 0 is equal 0 plus C, so C is equal to 0. So L1 is equal 0.8X. So this is F of X. So what's L1? L1 of X. It's equal 0.8 times X. This is L1 of X. So what's L2? So now we finished L1. We finished the function F. And I want to get L2, the equation of L2. So now, how can I get L2? If you get F, L1, so I want L2. What's L2? This is a line. We can write it. Be careful. If you have any line, you can write it Y minus Y1 over X minus X1 is equal the slope. What's the slope of this line? Minus 1.6. What's the point here? 100 and F100. F100. So here Y minus F100. So now we have the function F. Now we have the function F. So we can substitute with 100 over X minus 100 is equal minus 1.6. So what's L? This is Y. This is L. So L is equal minus 1.6 times X minus 100 plus F of 100. So we can get L2. This is L2. We can write it. Yes, it's very easy. So what's L2 of X? It's equal minus 1.6 times X minus 100. So open the bracket. X minus 100. Now we can get plus F 100. And now we have the function F. Now we have, this is function F for X over 5 minus 3X squared over 250. So we can substitute F100 and can get the result. So now, this is L2. Now we finish the first part. If you get the function F, L1 and L2, it's done. We finished the first part. And if I ask you another question, if we have this this function, be careful. If we have, this is a point B, and this is a point Q, for example. And I want the difference, we have the function f. I want the difference between f of 0 and f of 100. You can get it? It's very easy. Now we have the function f. So if I ask you what's the difference between the value of the function f at 0 and at 100, so f0 minus f100, we can get it. So this is the difference between f0 and f100. Clear? So now I have f of x. I have F L1, I have L2. The question now, can you plot it? Yes, we can plot it using the line space and F-plot or F-plot. We take it in the main class, if you remember, we can plot it by line space and by F-plot. We can write F-plot and plot these three functions. We can plot these three functions. Let's see. How can we plot these three functions in the same figure? But now be careful. Here we have the function. Here we have, this is the function f. And this f, I take it from 0 to 100. So I will plot the function f from 0 to 100. And I want to see this tangent line. I will take it from minus 10 to 0 or minus 20 to 0. It's fine, yani. And the same, this is 100 and this is 120. We can plot it 120, 110, and so on. So let's see. And be careful. If we use F plot, we can use hold on to plot it in the same figure. We take it in the class. So F plot, I want to plot L1, we know what's L1, and I will write here the interval. I want to take it from minus 20 to 0. Why? This is L1. Be careful. This is L1. This is F and this is L2. So I will take L1 from minus 20 to 0. This is L1. And I will take F from 0 to 100. And I will take it L2 from 100 to 120. So let's see. And we can dot the color, we can dot the line, but and so on. But now it's fine, it's fine. Just I write hold on. What's the meaning of hold on? Hold on, it means I'll plot another function or two functions, three functions, any functions that you want, but I want to put here both them in the same thing. So hold on, and then f plot the second one. F plot, this is the same one. I'll take it copy. I will take f, the function f, from 0 to 100. And the third one, I will take from 100 to 120. This is L2, be careful. This is L2. And after you finished, we can write hold off. So, and we can plot it. Let's see. Now this is the first ascent and the first drop, as you see. So, and also we can change the line widths. We can change the color. We can change the style of the line and so on. You can write the title, you can write X label, Y label, all of these, we can write it. So here, for the L1, if I want to make it white, line white, for example, line white. Put it in this quotation, be careful. Line white. And I wanted to make it 1.5, for example. It's fine. And also the same for the second and the third one. To make it clear. And you can run it. Control Enter. Be careful. So we can get it in this way. Clear? You can get it in this way. So, again, we can insert the title and X label, Y label, and so on. Clear? And we're done. This is the first part. For example, if I want to write the title, write that any title here with these two quotations. Be careful. So here I write Roland Koester design. Let's see. This is the title of the figure. This is the title. Again, we can write the X label and Y label and so on as we take it in the class. So we finished the first part. Inshallah, in the next video, we will start in the next part, the second part. I just want to modify it. So I will split it. This is function F. I will take it from 10 to 90. And then I will insert two cubic functions. And I am seeking to get it in a smooth way. I want to make it smoother and more comfortable as we take it in the first talk. So let's see you in the next class, inshallah.